Hello everyone and welcome to a new YouTube video by me, DuffDuffBuilding. Today back again with a new base build. Here you can see my new favorite base in all of Rust. For those who built the old 2x2 before, this one will definitely feel familiar. Its main features are still the usable honeycomb, my roof bunker, this time in another version, and my unlootable TC room. Here in the core we now have my trapped loot room, as well as some extra lockers, of which I became a huge fan in these past weeks, and of course my unlootable TC room. But how do we build this base? We will begin like you should begin in a real wipe, placing one square foundation for easier placement and wooden walls with a wooden door all around, so it's cheaper for the early stages. The TC goes about for a ninth of the length of the foundation deep. If freehanding isn't your thing, you can also use a barbecue for easier placement of the TC. A bag goes in the back next to the TC. Try to expand as early as you can. We will expand into a standard 2x2 with one additional triangle in the front, which will become our airlock. For early game storage, two large boxes can already be placed here and here. As soon as you can afford it, upgrade the entire base to stone and change out the wooden for metal doors. At this stage, you might need some extra storage. For this, simply expand the loot room. If you don't know how to do this, I will link to a tutorial on it in the description and the top right corner. Another double door goes here to equal out the raid cost of the base to 4 rockets. Normally here I would do a little jump cut to the finished core, but this time I decided to do a little time lapse with me talking over it instead. First we will add some garage doors here, as well as some furnaces to have the possibility to smelt for metal, of which we need quite a bit for this base. Next we will begin with the unlootable. For this we simply place a barbecue small box combo to the left and the right of the door frame. If you don't know how to build this loot room, I will link the tutorial on it right now. If you have problems with wearing this vending machine because of not being able to see, wearing a miner's helmet or candle hat might help with that problem. Once the unlootable is done, you should upgrade the entire core to metal, except this one wall that must be armored, and the frames that aren't shown to the outside, those can remain as stone. Now I will do this loot room. I chose this loot room because of its efficiency, as well as the shotgun traps that will point towards the entrance and slow down raiders coming from there. A locker goes here that, if placed correctly, shouldn't interfere with walking through the doors. Another locker goes in this corner with the T3 right next to it. A small box goes under the T3 and a campfire goes next to the locker in this corner. Now we come to the jump up. This time just add another triangle, as well as a ladder, and on top two window frames with reinforced glass window in the best case, and a double door. Next we place another double door with a full wall next to it and the rest filled in with windows. Expanding even more, we will place another two double doors with another two windows. Now with our entrance on the second floor, we will need to add in our entrance that will consist of a single door airlock, two windows and a roof leading up to it. Going through the other door, we will build our jump up, a window and a full wall with a half height floor fit right here, a double door that is raised by half goes on top, and now our jump up is already usable and we have roof access. Next we will do our first layer of honeycomb. Single triangles with walls and roofs go on the sides that so far are empty. Three triangles with three walls go under the entrance to fully cover it in. To begin with the usable honeycomb, we will first have to upgrade the honeycomb directly on the unlootable to metal and then combine the two triangles with another foundation and wall. This will again be covered in with walls and roofs to form a little room. To the side we will place two campfire large box combos on the bottom and the same half a layer up. Now close the loot room in with another wall and jump through the window. In here we will place 3 furnaces for more smelting. The same will be done on the other side, except placing 1 more triangle on each side and the wall facing the entrance being a window. Again, the furthest 2 triangles become a loot room in the same style as the previous one. This triangle here will be upgraded to metal and then filled in with whatever you want. I chose this design for an easy locker with extra storage next to the entrance. If you are unfamiliar with the whole usable honeycomb concept, I made an entire tutorial on that, that I will also link to in the top right corner. 3 small boxes go like this in front of it. Next we will finish the roof access that will also act as storage room and honeycomb. For this, surround the entire 2x2 core as well as the 3 triangles that made up our original entrance with half height walls and then separate them like this. Cover in everything except this one triangle with floors. Next do the final roof access consisting of 2 double doors opening inwards and a window frame with glass window. In this right compartment, place a repair bench with a small box underneath, as well as a large box to the left and a shotgun trap in between to stop people from going deep from the roof. In the left compartment, place 4 large boxes like this. Do this before placing the garage doors underneath, or they will stop you from placing the boxes. Next to this ramp up is space for a locker that can also be used for quick gear sets if you need to go to the roof or leave the base really fast. Finally, upgrade the honeycomb like this and add the roof triangle combo in these corners to add the second layer of honeycomb. Sadly, we need to add another triangle here attaching to the original airlock. I know it looks ugly, but otherwise this will become a weakness. Another roof triangle combo goes here. Always make sure to place the triangles in front of the windows so that later you have the possibility to add auto turrets. Upgrade the visible honeycomb closest to the TC to metal, just to make sure tunneling right to it is less appealing. The usable honeycomb should also be made entirely metal. The triangle next to the bunker needs to be fitted with the auto turret pod, even though you don't have an auto turret, because of these garage doors acting as honeycomb to ensure the 28 rocket rate cost. With the outside finished, we now go inside, placing garage doors everywhere on the second floor and upgrading a few walls to metal. This will finish the base from a rate cost standpoint. Embrasures go on all of these 4 windows, so that if you were to pick up the window glass to either access the auto turret or fight off door campers / raiders, they won't be able to enter the base from there. 2 beds fit over the TC room, this also makes the loot rooms easier to access. Next to the entrance, we will again have a utility room with space for a tier 2, battery, mixing table and 2 small boxes. Now we go to the extras. These will include finishing the other 2 auto turret pods with garage doors. Always make sure that the rollers are facing in so that you can open and close them from the safety of your own base. An auto turret goes on all of them. These can be upkept by 3 solar panels placed on the roof. Last we add our shooting floor. This doesn't add to the overall rocket cost, but makes online the space a lot harder. We did the half-height walls underneath, so that now we are able to place this pattern of peak downs. Now to finish off the video, I will show you the best way to raid the space in my opinion. 4 rockets into the center of the shooting floor to open these 2 loot rooms and reveal these floors. 8 rockets into the right floor to open it up above the unlootable. 15 rockets onto the armored floor, as well as into the metal wall next to it and the floor behind that. Once the armored is broken, 1 more rocket goes into this floor to open up the second loot room. In my opinion, this raid is now finished. This was the video, thank you all for watching, don't forget to subscribe, until next time, later!